In this video, we will see how to manage WordPress files using FTP. It's way more convenient than logging into the cPanel file manager every time you want to change a file. You can use it to upload themes or plugins and to download, edit, delete or rename files and many more. FTP stands for File Transfer Protocol, while SFTP is SSH File Transfer Protocol, which is an extension of Secure Shell Protocol. It involves encryption and is more secure. There is also FTPS, which is just FTP over SSL. To use FTP, we need an FTP client like FileZilla or WinSCP. In this tutorial, we will be using FileZilla. First, let us download FileZilla, which is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. Here I am going to download the 64-bit Windows version. Once the download is complete, run the installer and follow the wizard to install FileZilla on your machine. Then finish the setup and open the program. Next, we can connect to our server. For that, we need the FTP credentials. Usually, the username and password will be the same as that of your cPanel account. At most, hosts send you these credentials in the welcome email. For example, this is the email I got from Bluehost after signing up, which contains the FTP hostname, username, and password. The port number for FTP is usually 21. And for SFTP, it is usually 22. Some use different port numbers also. For example, FastComet uses 17177 as SFTP port number. If you still don't know the FTP details, you should ask your hosting provider so that they can help you. To connect to the remote server, you can use the Quick Connect bar here or use the Site Manager to save the connection details so that you don't have to enter it each time. Click New Site. Then give a name. And on the right side, set protocol to FTP or SFTP or FTPS, whichever your host supports. Below that, enter the host name, then the port number. Logon type, normal, username, enter your cPanel username, password, your cPanel password. Then click Connect or click OK to save the settings. From now onwards, FileZilla will remember your connection settings, so you can just connect to your site from the Site Manager in one click. Now that we have successfully connected, as an example, I will show you how to upload a WordPress theme using FTP. By the way, the currently active theme is 2019. On the left side, you can see the local site, which is our local machine. And on the right side is our remote site, which shows the files on our server. The theme I want to upload is OceanWP, which is located in the downloads folder in my local machine. Here is it. Currently, we are in the root folder of the hosting account. Our site files are in the public HTML directory, so we have to go there. If you host multiple sites in one account, the public HTML directory usually contains the files of your primary site, and all the subdomains and add-on domains will be in their respective subfolders. Our demo site is on a subdomain, so it is located inside this subfolder. To upload the theme, we have to go to the themes folder. Here you can see 2019, the currently active theme. Right click on the folder and click upload. At the bottom, you can watch the upload progress. The queue shows that the folder we are uploading contains 570 files. Since FileZilla does not support extracting zip files directly, we have to upload the uncompressed folder itself. So if our folder contains a lot of items, then it can take a while to complete. Once the upload is complete, we get a notification and you can see the uploaded folder on the right side. Now, if we go back to our themes page in the admin and reload it, we should see the newly uploaded theme. So that's how you can upload files with FTP. Next, I will show you how to edit a file. Suppose we want to add some code to the themes functions.php file. Open the themes folder, right click on the functions.php file, then click view or edit. Click OK to open the file in the default text editor. Now the PHP file is opened in Notepad, which is the default editor on Windows. Instead, you can use any of your favorite text editors. In my experience, Microsoft VS Code is a great option to edit PHP files. Let us add some code at the end of the file and save it. Now, if we go back to FileZilla, you see a notification saying the file has changed. Check Finish Editing and delete the local file option and click Yes. Now, the file will be uploaded back to the server. Let us refresh the directory to make sure the upload is successful. You can see the file size has changed. Next, we will see how to delete and rename files using FileZilla. Suppose you installed a plugin and it breaks your site and you are locked out of the WordPress admin area so that you cannot deactivate the plugin. Then to solve the issue, you can delete the plugin using FTP. Go to the plugins folder. You can either double click all the way or just enter the path here. Then right click on the plugin you want to delete and click delete. Next, let us see a crucial example where FTP comes really helpful when nothing else works. Suppose you don't know which plugin is creating the conflict and you are locked out of admin. In such a case, you will have to deactivate all the plugins. For that, rename the plugins folder to deactivate all plugins at once. Then you should regain access to the admin. Rename the folder back to original. Which will show up all the plugins again, but deactivated. Then you can activate them one by one to identify the faulty plugin. Once you are done, you can disconnect from the server. So that's how you can manage WordPress files using FileZilla. Hope you liked this video and thank you for watching.